guys, and welcome back to my channel. So I know it's been a hot minute since I've posted, at least posted like a normal video. The past few videos on my channel have just been vlogs, so I'm sorry about that. I've just been busy and also like in a slump, so I've kind of just felt like unmotivated to do a lot of stuff in my life that I probably should do, so I'm sorry about that. Also, excuse me if there's anything in my teeth. I literally just had Chick-fil-A, like I just finished eating, my trash is still on the table. But today's video is going to be a haul. I went to the mall this past weekend with the intent of buying a couple of things. I accomplished that. I bought the things that I wanted to get along with a couple of other things, so that's what I'm here to share with you guys. One of the things that I bought was this like t-shirt dress, so this is really like all you need to see of it, because honestly it's just this little detail, this little white detail, and then the rest of it's just black, and it's about mid-thigh. It's a t-shirt dress. I bought this, it was like $10 at Forever 21. I bought this dress because we were walking around the mall, and we were in a store, and Micah's like, your pants are ripping. And I was like, okay, cool. So the pair of shorts that I had on had previously ripped already, and I had sewn them back up, but I guess like, I don't know, I'm not a very good sewer. So I think the thread just like was done and started coming undone, and so my pants were starting to re-rip, I guess, in the same place. So I was like, okay, well, now I feel weird about it. He said it didn't really, like, you couldn't see my ass, which was a good thing, but at the same time I felt really self-conscious about it. So I was like, I'm just gonna run into Forever 21, find something cheap to throw on. I was gonna try to find some shorts. They don't have shorts in my Forever 21. They have skirts. They have those like corduroy button-up denim shirt skirts, but they don't have shorts. They have denim everything but shorts. I guess because it's not like short season anymore, but still, we have a good decent amount of hot weather until fall graces us. But regardless, they didn't have any shorts there, so I just settled with this t-shirt dress. And that's all that you need to know about that. Anyway, so that was a long ramble about this, but I bought this t-shirt dress there. I also bought from the mall. I went there with the intent of buying two things, but I ended up getting a couple more things. So I went to FYE, is that what it's called? FYE in the mall. And I bought these little like squishy things because they're super cute, and I saw them last time I was in FYE, but we were already like checked out and everything, so I didn't want to go back through the checkout line. So I was like, well, if I come back and they're still here, I'm gonna get them. And they were, so I did. And they're nothing special. They were literally like $5 for all three of these, but there's this little kitty. He's super cute, and he like squishes belly. There's like little videos going around of these when squishies were like a really big thing. There's this little polar bear, he's pink, he does the same thing, he's just kind of like squishy. They're made of this like silicone-y material, but they're very satisfying to touch. And then there's this kitty, and the same thing, he's just squishy. They're just like little squishy, silicone-y stress relief things. I thought they were super cute, so they were only $5, so I picked those up while I went to the mall. And then we went into Bed Bath & Beyond slash, what is it, White Barn? And I wanted to look around at their scents, and I wanted to get another eucalyptus mint candle slash the aromatherapy stress relief candle. I have one in my bathroom right now that is a, what's it called, a soy candle, but it's really, really small. And it's handmade. We sell them at the gallery, which is really awesome, but it is really small, so it burns really quickly. And previous to that candle, I bought that candle as like a filler candle because my candle before that, the eucalyptus mint from White Barn, has like this much candle left in it, but the wick is completely burned out, so I can't burn the candle anymore. We have one of those like wax melters, so I heard that you can just like get the wax out of the candle, put it in the wax melter, and still be able to use up the rest of the wax. But right now we still have wax in our wax melter, so, you know, anyway. But I might save that candle, I don't know. But I did go ahead and buy the aromatherapy version. There's really no difference in the smell at all. One is just from the aromatherapy line, the other one is just called eucalyptus mint. They both smell the exact same. This even says eucalyptus plus spearmint, so they're basically the same, they just have like different labels on the candle. This is, I don't know what it is about this smell, but this smell is so intoxicating. It is so good. I was just standing there in line with my candle, just like huffing this candle basically in Bed Bath & Beyond because I love this smell. And they're having a sale. Usually these 3-wick candles, these large ones are about $25. But they're having a sale where they were like 13 bucks, which is a really great deal. But I don't know if it's stress relieving because of the scent or if it's like, I don't know. So the whole point of the aromatherapy line is like, this is a stress relieving candle. You burn it and you inhale the scents and it's supposed to relieve stress. I don't know if that's like necessarily the case. But it does, like, it is a very calming scent. It's a very relaxing scent. I usually burn it when I take a bath. It's just such a good smell. It's like fresh and it's just, it's a very relaxing smell. I don't know what it is. Maybe there's some truth behind this like whole aromatherapy thing. But it just smells so good. The sticker has a bubble in it. That's the first time I've ever seen that. Oh well. But I love it. It smells so good. But while we were there, Micah said, because we were browsing around and he knew that I wanted to get another eucalyptus mint because they're my favorite. Micah's like, get you another candle and I'll pay for it. And I was like, okay, cool. So the other candle I got is another one of my absolute favorite scents. And I was so worried last year when I discovered this scent that they weren't going to bring it back because Bath & Body Works does this really stupid, terrible thing where they make these incredibly amazing smells and then they just discontinue them and it just drives me insane. So I remember I had a scent long time ago, I don't even remember what it was called now, that I loved and then they discontinued it, yet they have like, what is it, like Japanese Blossom like for 20 years now. Anyway, they came out with this scent last year. I think it was a new scent for them last year. It's called Marshmallow Fireside. I literally have a candle upstairs, the exact same candle, Marshmallow Fireside, upstairs that I haven't burned at all because I was afraid that they weren't going to continue making them. So I wanted to save it for this upcoming fall season because it is literally the perfect fall smell. I don't know what it is. This just has different packaging than the one that I have upstairs. But it's Marshmallow Fireside. I'm going to read the notes. It says, toasted marshmallows, smoldering woods, fire-roasted vanilla, and crystallized amber. And it has this, like, I don't know how to describe it. When I smell this smell, like, you smell marshmallows, it kind of brings you into, like, maybe, like, a cool summer night. Like you're sitting by the fireside, you're toasting marshmallows, like that's what this smell reminds me of. Because when you smell it, you get those notes. You get the hint of like marshmallow and then you start smelling like the kind of like burnt wood smell with mixed in with this like, I don't know, like you know how fall air, it's not like dense, but it's like kind of dense. I don't know if that makes sense, but this is like the perfect fall smell and the perfect like cozy smell, I guess is what I'm trying to think of. Like fall is a very cozy time, like you want to be warm, you want to be cozy, you want to be wrapped in blankets, and it's a good transition smell from like fall to winter. It's just such a nice smell. I love this candle, so I'm glad that they brought it back. I will probably go through this candle very quickly. So luckily I have another one upstairs, so I'll probably use that one first and then go through this one just because that's the order I bought them in. But anyway, those are the two candles I got and I love them. They are my absolute favorite. So the last thing that I got at the mall are Tragus jewelry. So I have one of the new ones in right now, which is pretty simple. I'll try to show you one up close, although they're really small, so I don't know how well I'm going to be able to show it to you, but they come in pairs of two, basically, so there's like two of each kind, so you have six total because there's three different kinds in this pack. But I went to Spencer's and I picked up this Tragus jewelry. So this is the one that I have in my ear right now. Like I said, they came in packs of two, so I have another one like this, and then there's two of these, which are just like plain, Just has the plain like silver ball in it, nothing. There we go. Nothing too spectacular, just very generic. Ooh, I dropped it. And then the last pair in here is this one, which I don't know if you can tell, but can you tell? Maybe. But the jewel in there is like a pink color. I don't know if that's picking up very well, but there's two of each, so two of the plain, two of the pink, and two of the just like, I don't know, diamond type jewel. And this pack was $17, I believe, from Spencer's. And they didn't ask me for a Pierce the Nation card because I have one, but I didn't give it to them because the lady didn't ask me. That's fine, whatever. But the reason why I got these Tragus jewelries, one, I have one Tragus jewelry that is like a straight bar that goes like straight through. It has like a little gem here and it goes straight through the back. The reason why I wanted to get this type of Tragus jewelry, well, one, I used to have a couple of the like hoop type jewelry for my tragus, but I lost the balls that go in it to keep it in my ear, so I needed to get new ones. And the reason why is because I bought these like knockoff AirPods off of Amazon. These are $38-ish, and when I wear earbuds, I cannot wear them when I have my like straight bar tragus jewelry in. It has to be this like curved bar because the back of the straight bar sticks out too much in the back that I can't put earbuds like in my ear. I just like, I physically can't because my jewelry's in the way. But if I have this type of jewelry in my tragus, then I can slide it kind of like behind it and it works out. So I have, well, obviously I have two pairs. But obviously I have two of these because I didn't just buy one, but they're kind of like knockoff AirPods because I didn't want to spend $150 on AirPods. And these work, I mean, obviously I think AirPods would be better quality. These are not the best quality headphones. I mean, the speaker in them is fine. I'm not really that picky. As long as it's not staticky, I'm not picky about the sound. The only thing I am picky about is one, maybe it's just because of the shape, maybe I just have small ears, I don't know what it is. These are kind of uncomfortable in my ears. Like, after a while, for whatever reason, the left one is much more comfortable than the right one. The right one starts to hurt my ear, and I have to, like, kind of move it around. Sometimes I have to take it out for a minute and put it back in because it starts to hurt my ear. The other thing about these is the sound, like I said, the sound quality is fine. It doesn't bother me. Although sometimes I'll be watching a video on my phone and sometimes like one earbud will go out and I'll have to kind of like turn my head a weird way and it'll kick back in. It's really bizarre. I don't know why that happens. And then another thing is that like if I'm watching a video on my phone, the audio doesn't align with the video. So the video will be ahead of the audio that I'm hearing, which to some people like drives him crazy. For Micah, he cannot stand if the audio doesn't match up with the video. It drives him absolutely nuts. Me, it doesn't really bother me that much. I'm kind of used to it. I do this thing where I plug my phone into the aux cord in my car and I'll set it on my phone mount and I'll play YouTube videos while I'm driving. And not because I like really in-depth watch them when I'm driving, but I've become more, like, I enjoy listening to YouTube videos more than I like listening to music, which is a really odd thing. And so I like to have that in the background. And so, but if I do glance over, the audio is never aligned with the people speaking through my car. So I've been used to that. But the reason why I bought these earbuds is because of a couple of things. So I have like Beats headphones, but those are like really big, really bulky. And I don't mind wearing them like around the house or when I'm editing or whatever, that's fine. But I just started school back last Wednesday and I have a 2-hour break in between one of my classes and it's really boring. And last time I had my 2-hour break, I was like, man, I wish I had headphones. And I was like, but also my phone was dying. Like my phone was on like 30%. So I wanted wireless earbuds. They had to be Bluetooth, obviously, because that way I could charge my phone through my charging port because I have an iPhone 7, which doesn't have a headphone jack. So I could charge my phone and listen to music slash watch videos during my break. So that's the reason why I got these little headphones. They have like a charging thing. They're basically like knockoff AirPods. So they have this case. You plug this case in through the little lightning cable and it charges the headphones. I find that the charge lasts just fine for me. It doesn't bother me. I've never run out of charge because I don't, you know, use these for that long of a time period, so I don't have to worry about the charge going out really. The only gripe I really have about it is just that it's a little bit uncomfortable and the earbud goes out every now and then and the audio doesn't match up. So if you want to justify, but to me that's okay because rather than me spending $150, I can spend significantly less than that and get okay quality headphones, you know? Like, it doesn't bother me that much. Everything that is, you know, not so great about these headphones doesn't bother me because of the price, you know? Anyway, so that is everything that I have for this haul. I did buy a lot of pet stuff because Yuna's going through training, so I bought a lot of stuff for her to train with. So I might do a whole separate haul on that. So I don't know if you want to see two haul videos back to back, but I don't really know what else to do. I could do like a back to school video, but I don't really know what to talk about because I mean, well, I feel like most of us are on the same page of like school really sucks, but you kind of have to do it type of feeling. I mean, I don't know a lot of people who like genuinely enjoy to go to school, but I'm not one of those people. So anyway, I'll try to think of something interesting to post on Thursday, but anyway, that is everything that I have for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, give it a thumbs up, go down below, subscribe, hit that bell icon so you don't miss when I do post. And other than that, I hope you guys have an awesome day. I'm sorry that I haven't been super active lately. I'll try to get better at that. Wish me luck, but I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Bye!